Day. Today we're getting some big fuel upgrades for the 12 valve Cummins, the first gen. I haven't done this video step by step only because there's a million videos out there on the internet about how to install 12 valve injectors. This truck has been out for what, 25 years at this point? So yeah, there's a ton of videos. So what I'm just showing you is the interesting stuff, like what I'm throwing in there, what the old injectors look like. I'm pretty much just giving you a rundown of that. If you want to actually know how to install them step by step, like I said, there's tons of high quality videos on the internet or on YouTube, just search it up. But one thing I did have to show you guys is these old injectors, man. I'll show you the rest of them here in a second, but this one stuck out to me. It pulled so hard. By the way, this is my little homemade injector puller. All credit goes to another guy on YouTube. I'll put his information down below. He actually came up with this little idea. Well, he didn't come up with it, but he's the one who showed me. It's just a 12 by 1.5 right-hand thread lug nut. It's a Toyota lug nut. I picked it up at O'Reilly's. It's welded on from the guys Chase and Colton over at Iron Ape Fabs and Coating. You guys may have seen this video a while back, but it's a, I believe it's a 3/4 inch bolt that's 2 inches long, and then like I said, that nut's welded onto the end of it, and then just a nut and washer to go along with it. And there's also a spacer. This is how I'm pulling them. I don't know if I showed that quick clip a minute ago, but that's how I'm pulling them. This little spacer pretty much just covers up. I've already put one of the new power driven diesel injectors in there, but pretty much if I wanted to pull it, I just stick that down there, stick the spacer down there, stick the lug nut on it, screw it down tight, and then hold the bolt tight with this, my little half inch ratchet. And then with the other side, I've been just using adjustable pliers to screw the nut down and pull that injector out. So like I said, I'll put his information down below. He tells it a lot more in depth, but yeah, that is how I'm pulling these old injectors. They look crazy. Right now, currently putting the fuel lines back together as well. These things turned out really good. We got them all powder coated and stuff. Got our powder coated valve covers, alternator bracket, and brake fluid cover. Here is the rest of the five power driven diesel 7x11 sack, 148 degree, 248 bar. There is a slight needlework in there. If you guys want any injectors or any sort of, that has my information on it, but if you guys want your injectors, turbos, I got my second gen turbo S362 that I run on my second gen 24 valve outside. I got that from Power Driven Diesel. They have everything, they machine it the way you need it to be, just so it's a drop in. All you literally need to do is buy the two bolts for the oil fitting on the bottom with their turbo kits that they have for the second gens. It's ridiculous. And you can just buy, you know, the stainless steel or whatever bolts you want to buy. I want to say they were 3/8, but that's the only thing you need to buy as far as their turbo kits. They're really knowledgeable on these Cummins trucks, these 12 valves and 24 valves. I'm actually going to be linking down their YouTube channel below. They have a legit YouTube channel. You can learn so much. So make sure you guys are definitely checking them out on their YouTube and their Instagram. I'll put their information down below for that. But let's go check out these other older injectors. Everything is going to button up and look really good when this is all done. Just been trying to knock out as much as possible. But here is the rest of them. The other five, you just of course seen the sixth one. And wow, they look terrible. I'm honestly surprised the truck ran as good as it did with the injectors in the shape that they are in. But then again, it is a Cummins, so you probably shoot it with a 50 cal straight down the block and it'll run for at least a little bit. But yeah, Cummins has always surprised me. Just the durability and the longevity these motors can have. This truck has 300,000 miles on it. Actually, 330,000 miles on this 12 valve. And obviously, the injectors have never been replaced. So the truck is going to get a lot better fuel mileage now and a lot better power. A lot more horsepower is about to come. And still, we're going to have a lot better fuel mileage because New injectors is something that can really, really improve your truck. They have a budget line series over at Power Driven Diesel. A very, very smart idea to go ahead and upgrade your injectors through Power Driven Diesel, just because the price point you're gonna pay for these injectors is just, you can't beat it. A lot of people use them actually in the Cummins community. So you probably have heard of them before, but I'm gonna continue to knock this project out. I don't know if you guys already know, but we'll show you the other side. I'm knocking out a few projects at once. Once I get just like the injectors, I'm not gonna do step by step with the air dog install over here, because there's a million videos out there on the internet. So I'm mounting it right now, but I'll probably show you guys the down and dirty, you know, a quick little, hey, this is how you do it kind of thing, not just step by step. Like, I'm not gonna show you how to set up the mount. Like, that's really, really easy. And then of course, if you guys did it, check it out. We have our Deviant Race Parts supply and return sump. Make sure you guys check out that video. It was a video when I had came back from a month-long break, so a lot of people missed out on that video. So make sure you guys check it out. I did do an install video on that. Just tying up a lot of loose ends, trying to make this truck run a lot better. So we'll check up with you here in a little bit once we get a little bit more knocked out. Figured I might as well mention this while I'm down here doing it. What I'm doing now is I'm just cleaning out the holes that the injectors go in. Down there, it's all dirty and oily after 330,000 miles. You can't really blame it, so... I'm just taking a rag and about a 6-inch 3/8 extension, some carb choke cleaner, Gumont is the brand. I'm just spraying down the rag, sticking it down there, twisting it around a little bit, just cleaning out the holes, doing it like 3 or 4 times until my rag's clean. As you can see right there, that is a 6-cylinder first swipe. So that is what you may have down there in your injector holes. And like I said, that's just taking fuel economy and taking money out of your pocket. So make sure you don't skip this step. All right guys, just a little update. We're test fitting the fuel lines now. We got the longer ones on here, the ones that go to the 4th, 5th, and 6th cylinder. We got a few injectors in right now. Got them all cleaned out. We're about to throw the rest of the injectors, 2 more injectors in there. But right now I'm just scoring up using a Scotch-Brite scoring pad, or scuff pad, I guess you could say. Just getting it ready for the new gasket. We got a new gasket. We're getting a lot of progress done, guys. We got our powder coated part, our master cylinder cover. We've got a paint up around it, but we weren't about to pull this entire thing off just to powder coat this entire piece. I coated it before I put it in, but it just freaking already looks bad because, you know, brake fluid, if it touches anything, it just looks crappy immediately. We've also got our new alternator bracket, which is powder coated. We got that in there. Everything needs to be cleaned. Everything you see has smudges of just grease and oil. So nothing is clean. Nothing is what it's gonna look like when it's all done. So just keep that in mind as well before you comment. But yeah, just wanted to give you guys a quick update. That's where we're at. Alrighty guys, so here's the last injector from Power Driven Diesel going in the 12 valve. I actually had to redo those first two that I did because I forgot to put the freaking copper washers at the bottom, and I already rechecked and made sure. It's one of those things that I was kind of not really paying attention when I was doing it. I've done it so many times that it's just something you can always forget. So I'm happy that I caught it after two, and it was very easy. I just pulled the first and the sixth that I already had done and went ahead and put copper washers on all of them. I don't know if you can see, but like I said, I went ahead and checked all the old ones and made sure that they had their copper washers with them and I didn't double stack. And I, of course, went ahead and looked into all the injector holes. I don't know if you guys can really see in that injector hole, but I am glad that I went ahead and took, I'm kind of glad that I forgot, honestly, because I went ahead and when I pulled the first and sixth injector, I realized that I needed to clean a little bit more because there was a little bit of oil on these brand new injectors. So I triple checked, and I've been out here for like an hour and a half just cleaning the inside of those injector holes, because the last thing you want to do on injector install is rush it. And I broke my number one rule. So like I said, I forgot the copper washer, but we got it in there now. And I'm glad because I needed to double clean, or I needed to clean more. And I definitely don't want to rush through this. So this is our final injector. All you got to do is pretty much match it up where that ball is right there. There's going to be a little groove for it to fall into. You just put it in like so, kind of shake it around. It shouldn't be able to move too much. Then you go ahead, you take your retainer nut, slide it on there. I like to be real easy with these things. I don't like to even get any residue on the top or in the bottom. I went ahead and took a vacuum actually before I put my new intake cover on. Well, not new, but powder coated intake cover on. Took a vacuum and I vacuumed out everything around here, my shop vac over there. But yeah, this retainer nut is gonna go down to 44 foot-pounds. Boom. Double check it, and that's your injector install. Got all six done. They're all looking really good. I cannot wait to fire this truck up. It's definitely gonna be rolling some serious coal now. But that is probably where I'm gonna end out this video, guys. I know it wasn't the most exciting video, but once we get this thing on the road, which will be very soon, trust me, those injectors are gonna be freaking really exciting. It's gonna light up that turbo. You guys know we got a little bit bigger than an HX40. It's a completely rebuilt turbo, so that thing is gonna be whistling. It already was whistling with those really old injectors. My question for you, I'm gonna leave this video with a question. Now, as you can see here, we have a huge problem. Obviously, my heater core, if you guys are new to the channel or didn't see that, I have a brand new heater core, but it was leaking into the cab. So I bypassed it again like the original owner, but I can't remember the setup he had with this hose. Do you guys suggest anything that maybe I can just go pick up where it's not gonna have that huge kink in the hose where it can run back and be circulated through the engine, or as far as my coolant goes? Because right now, of course, there's a huge kink in it. And like I said, I've never had to bypass a heater core before. This is the first time. So let me know what you suggest on what's the best way to bypass a heater core on a 12 valve. Remember, we're limited on our options because this is 12. I'm new to 12 valve engine, right? So let me know, you 12 valve junkies out there, what you would suggest. I'd appreciate if you guys could comment that down below. That'd really mean a lot. Also leave a like down below if you enjoyed the video. As soon as we get this thing up and running, you guys will definitely see the video. Us probably doing a burnout, doing some stupid stuff with these new injectors in here. Head studs are coming. Don't freak out. Head studs are coming. It's a build. It's going to take a while. Working on the air dog a little bit more today and just tying up a ton of loose ends. Of course, we got the new starter that you guys will be seeing. You guys will probably be seeing that video within the next week, the new starter we have going on the 12 valve. So stay tuned for that. 24 valve is running great. She's sitting out there. But yeah, that's going to do it, guys. It's just been a busy day at the house getting stuff done. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you leave a like down below, and we will see you in the next one. You got me rockin' rollin'